Hi, guys. So this is Dr. Jarvis, and my mailbox filleth up. Y'all are asking some questions, and I want to see if I can get some quick answers for you. This one is going to be really quick. Anne asks about racemic epinephrine and what the difference between racemic epinephrine and regular epinephrine is. So I'm going to give you a couple of paper references, and we're going to talk about some clinical studies. But if you have short attention, let me give you the bottom line. There ain't no difference. Same thing. Now, what is the longer answer? So racemic epinephrine and epinephrine, normal epinephrine, are stereoantimers of each other. So they're isomers. And basically what we're talking about here is the same molecule. And as we know, a molecule is a combination of atoms that are chemically bound to each other in a certain order. So a molecule can have the same molecular structure, meaning the number of atoms and the order that the atoms are connected to, but have a different three-dimensional orientation. And what that means is that they end up being mirror images of each other, and that's what stereoisomers are. So if you have, you can have a molecule that has what we call a left-handed version, or an L isomer, or a D isomer, and that's what we call a right-handed version. So L isomers and D isomers, and they're from Latin, and there's boring Latin stuff involved, but that's where we get the L and the D. So the normal epinephrine, when you open up a drug box, get out your cardiac epinephrine, push it in, that is L epinephrine, so levorotary epinephrine. Racemic epinephrine is L epinephrine plus dextrorotary epinephrine, or D epinephrine. So it is both the left-handed epinephrine and the right-handed epinephrine. It's the full meal deal. All right, so what is the difference? Well, it turns out that the effect you get from a molecule has a lot to do with its three-dimensional orientation, how it fits into receptors. So you would not believe the weird look Dan is giving the camera right now. It's kind of creepy. So the handedness has an effect. See, I told you. Really?
Continue.
Okay. So the handedness of the molecule has an effect on the impact, what is going to happen. Now, this is where we get these customized drugs like albuterol and levoalbuterol. They're just stereoisomers of each other, and levoalbuterol is Xopenex. And typically what happens is a drug manufacturer will make these so you can prove that they're different molecules and therefore fall under different patents. And the drug manufacturer will say, in the case of Xopenex, well, it has, because it's a different isomer, it has less increase in heart rate. Now, clinical studies will tell you there is no difference in heart rate, but let's not let that stop us from charging more for the same drug. When it comes to racemic epinephrine, remember both hands, L and D, turns out the D isomer of epinephrine is inactive. It really doesn't have any effect. So we wouldn't expect racemic epinephrine, which is more expensive than regular epinephrine, to have any different effect, except for one small thing. And that's racemic epinephrine is more expensive than regular epinephrine. Therefore, it's got to be better. Well, let's see. If the D isomer doesn't have any impact, then regardless of that, racemic epinephrine should not be any different in its clinical effectiveness from epinephrine. Well, it turns out there are two studies, actually there are a lot more than this, I'm just going to hit two, that will say the same thing. So one is by a gentleman named Weissman. Well, I'm assuming it's a gentleman, terribly sexist of me, maybe not. Dr. Weissman, let me do that. And the title is A Prospective Randomized Controlled Double-Blinded Trial Comparing L-Epinephrine and Racemic Epinephrine in the Treatment of Croup. And this was published in Pediatrics way back in 1992. And so they randomized patients to get either L epinephrine, regular epinephrine, or racemic epinephrine. And because it was randomized, the two groups of kiddos were the same. They both had croup, and they were both had similar characteristics. And they looked for resolution of croup. Both of them worked great. Croup was resolved, the same percentage in both of them. And they also looked at the proportion of patients with side effects, tachycardia, tachypnea, hypertension, side effects, nausea. No difference in any of them. Their conclusion? Ain't no damn difference. Go with the cheaper drug. I like that conclusion. Okay, well, what about in adults? So the next trial was by Dr. Nutman, and the title of the paper was Racemic versus L-epinephrine in the treatment of post-intubation laryngeal edema, results from a prospective randomized double-blind study. And this was published in Critical Care Medicine way back in 1994. And I realize some of you probably were not born in 1994, as much as that pains me to think about. So they did the same thing, double blind. The doctor doesn't know what they're giving. The patient doesn't know what they're getting. And they randomized patients to L-epinephrine or racemic epinephrine. And by the way, in both of these, the normal epinephrine was nebulized. And that's how you can blind it. So these were patients who had been intubated and got extubated. And one of the problems is after you've been intubated for a while, you get this laryngeal edema and you get stridor. Looks a whole lot like croup, but in an adult, and it's non-viral, and it's because of this mechanical irritation. So again, they found the same thing. No difference in resolution of stridor. Epinephrine nebulized works great. No difference in increase in heart rate. No difference in systolic blood pressure. No difference in nausea. There was a difference in increased respiratory rate with the L-epinephrine compared to the racemic epinephrine. But it sounds to me like one of these things where if you study enough variables, outcome variables, you're going to find a difference. So they looked at each of these variables at 20 minutes, 40 minutes, 60 minutes, 2 hours, and 4 hours. And they found it at 40 minutes and at 60 minutes, which suggests to me that A, it's not clinically significant, and B, it's random effect. So, bottom line, there is no difference outside of the chemistry lab between racemic epinephrine and L-epinephrine or normal epinephrine, the stuff we carry, other than the concentration. Racemic epinephrine just happens to ship in a higher concentration and is more expensive. So hopefully that answered the question, and thank you for asking it. And I know I still have some additional questions to get to. Please, if you have any questions, send them in. And just attach the subject clinical mailbox. I appreciate it. Thanks a lot, y'all.